Now we are going to define the sum of ideals. So sum of ideals. Ideals means two-sided ideals. So suppose I1 and I2 are two ideals offering R. So now define I1 plus I2, that is called the sum of ideals I1 and I2. This is defined as the set of elements of the form A plus B such that A is in I1 and B is in I2. So actually when you will write this sum, this will also become an ideal. So let us check. So let us check that is it ideal or not. So now because I1 is an ideal and I2 is an ideal, so these are the subrings. So 0 will be inside I1 and I2. So 0, which we can write as 0 plus 0, will always belongs to I1 plus I2. So this set is non-empty. So I am going to check that it is an ideal or not. So the first step is to show that it is non-empty. Now take two elements in this set. Take A1 plus B1 and A2 plus B2 in I1 plus I2. So clearly A1 and A2 belongs to I1 and B1 and B2 belongs to I2. Now what about A1 plus B1 minus A2 plus B2? So by the properties of ring, we can write it as A1 plus B1 minus A2 minus B2. And because the ring is commutative with respect to addition, so we can collect A1. So this is A1 minus A2 we can write, plus B1 minus B2 we can write, because the addition is commutative. Now this is an element of I1 because I1 is an ideal and A1 A2 are the elements of I1, and similarly B1 minus B2 will belongs to I2. So this whole element belongs to I1 plus I2. So I take two element and their difference is in I1 plus I2. So now the third thing which we need to verify is that, so take an element R in R and A plus B in I1 plus I2, then we will show that their product is in I1 plus I2. So how? So R times A plus B, by the distributive law we can write it as RA plus RB. But now I1, A belongs to I1 and I1 is an ideal, so R times A will also be in I1, and similarly R times B will also be in I1. So this whole thing belongs to I1 plus I2. So it means I1 plus I2 is a left ideal. Now similarly, if we multiply it by R like this, then it is AR plus BR, and by the same argument this belongs to I1 plus I2 because I1 and I2 are the ideals. So it means I1 plus I2 is a right ideal, this is left ideal, so it means I1 plus I2 is an ideal, this is an ideal. So sum of two ideals is again an ideal. I would like to give you example. Suppose I take NZ, NZ is an ideal of Z, and I take another ideal MZ, and now this will become an ideal, but you know the ideals of Z are of the form something into Z. So what is that something? Please, I am giving you a hint and please verify that it will turns out to be like this. So it will be the GCD of N and M. So I leave it as a exercise to verify it. Now I am going to define the product of two ideals. So now let me define the product of two ideals. Before going to the product, let me give you one more information that any element, if you take A in I1, then A can always be written as A plus 0, so it will belongs to I1 plus I2. And similarly, if you will take B in I2, then B can be written as, sorry, so A can be written as A plus 0. So it will belongs to I1 plus I2. Similarly, B can be written as 0 plus B and it will belongs to I1 plus I2. So this simply implies that I1 union I2. So I1 is contained in and I2 is contained in I1 plus I2. So I1 plus I2 contains I1 as well as I2. So I1 union I2 is contained in I1 plus I2. So now product of two ideals, again suppose I1 and I2 are two ideals of a ring R. Suppose these are two ideals of a ring R. Now we define the product of the ideals as define I1 into I2. This I1 into I2 is called the product of ideals. This is a set summation AB. So AIBI, I is varying from 1 to n, such that AI is an element of I1, BI is an element of I2, and n is varying over the set of natural numbers, so it may vary. So this is the sum of the product of the elements of I1 and I2. So let us again verify that this is an ideal. So you may write it as, my claim is that I1 I2 is an ideal. So one thing you can see that 0 can be written as 0 into 0. So this belongs to I1 into I2. So this set is non-empty. Suppose I take one element summation AIBI, I is varying from 1 to n. And I take another element summation I is varying from 1 to k, some CIDI, where AI belongs to I1. CI belongs to I1, BI belongs to I2, and DI belongs to I2. And now, so this element belongs to I1, I2. So this implies, what about their difference? Summation AIBI, I is varying from 1 to n, minus summation I is varying from 1 to k, CIDI. Now in this set, expressions of these forms are there. So this is sum of products of elements of I1, I2, and this is also sum of products of elements of I1, I2, and this whole thing, if you will consider, this is of this form. The whole expression, after taking the difference also, this whole expression is the sum of products of the elements of I1 and I2. So this whole expression will belongs to I1, I2. So if you take two elements, their difference is in I1 and I2. Now we need only to verify that if I take some element from the ring R, so take R in R and I take one element summation ai bi, I is varying from 1 to n in i1 i2. So let us multiply it. So r times summation ai bi, I is varying from 1 to n. This by the distributivity law, it can be written as r ai bi, I is varying from 1 to n. Now multiplication is associative operation, so we can write it as r ai into bi, I is varying from 1 to n. Now note one thing, that whenever you will take r ai, then r into ai will be an element of i1, because i1 is an ideal. So in this sum, the first component is always an element of i1, so this belongs to i1 into i2. Similarly, if you multiply from right side, so what does it mean? It means that this is an left ideal. Now ai bi, and suppose I multiply r from right side, then by the distributive law, you can write it as summation ai bi, and you can multiply r, I is varying from 1 to n. By the associativity operation of the ring, you can write it as ai bi into r, I is varying from 1 to n. But because i2 is an ideal, so bir will be in i2. So this element is in i1 and this element is in i2. So this is an expression of this form. So this belongs to i1, i2. So clearly, this is an, so i1, i2 is an ideal. Here you can note one thing, that whenever you are taking the product, because ai belongs to i1, so ai into bi will always belongs to i1, because i1 is an ideal. And similarly, because bi belongs to i2, so ai into bi belongs to i2. So it means, whatever the expression we are writing, this expression will belongs to i1 as well as i2. So always we can say that i1, i2 will be contained inside i1 intersection i2, because this ideal will always be contained in the ideal i1 as well as in ideal i2. So let me give you one example. Suppose I take MZ and I take NZ. So what will be? So this should be an ideal, because this is an ideal of Z and this is an ideal of Z. So their product should also be an ideal of Z. So what is that ideal? So any ideal will be of the form something times Z. So my question is that what is this ideal? So now I am leaving it to you to verify that it is equal to MNZ.